Hello, my name is Erin from Juniperin Oaks. I am a crochet pattern designer. I like to take interesting stitches like these and create crochet designs for you to work up to use around your home. Today, I am so excited to share with you the Desert Flower Pillow. This is a brand new pattern that I'm just releasing, and isn't it a beaut? I am excited to be releasing this pattern as a crochet along, so you can make it along with me. This will be a free cal that I'm running on my website, so whenever a new section is released, the webpage will be updated with the instructions for that section. And then in the Juniperin Oaks Crochet Community Facebook group, we're sharing pictures, asking questions, and really just helping each other out learn how to crochet this jasmine stitch desert flower pillow. All the fun officially starts on May 15th. Don't worry if you're watching this after the fact. All of the instructions are still available for free on my website, as long as Juniperin Oaks is still a thing. But before I dive too deep into the details, let me tell you the materials that you're going to need in order to make this pillow for the cow. The first thing that you're going to need is yarn. The yarn that I used is from High Desert Yarn. My friend Joanna hand dyes this beautiful yarn. She created this custom color based on some inspiration that I gave her. I first used this design last year when I crocheted up a romper for my baby Piper. So this colorway, she called it Malvas for Piper, because of the beautiful malva flower. This color is mauve, and my daughter, of course, her name is Piper. So the colorway that I used is Malvas for Piper. You're gonna need 3 skeins of this yarn. Joanna is making this yarn available for all of you to purchase as well. She does have limited kits available on her Etsy shop. Now, if pink isn't your thing, she has lots of other colorways too. So for the duration of the cow, she's offering 10% off of 3 skeins of her worsted weight yarn. So you can mix and match colors. You can get 3 of all the same color. And if you don't like pink, or if this is already all sold out, maybe it is because this is gonna be such a popular cow, you can definitely choose any other colorway to work this up with us. So I used up all 3 of my skeins already for my pillow, so I don't have any to show you here live on this video, but I do have a bit left over and I just wanted to show it to you. Look at this cute little cake. Speaking of cake, she does have mini skeins, and I use this yarn for my Bookmar Bonanza Cal that I'm running this year, where you can use these cute little mini skeins to work up some bookmarks every month of the year. Now, if you don't like hand-dyed yarn, if wool isn't your thing, if maybe Joanna's run out of yarn because we just sold her out of her shop, then you can use any other worsted weight yarn that you would like. You're gonna need about 660 yards of it. Okay, so that's the yarn that you're gonna need. After you kind of pick it out, then let's talk about the hook. So the hook that I used is a size G hook. It's a 4 mm hook. Now, people say that I crochet kind of tight, and in order to meet my gauge, you might need to use a smaller hook size, like a 3 or 3.5. Now, the third thing that you're going to need is a pillow insert. The pattern is written for a 12 by 12 inch pillow insert. You can get those at a craft store. You can get them on Amazon. I'll affiliate link an option below. Now, you can create any size pillow that you want. Just know you'll have to use a different yarn or a different hook or change your stitch count and row count and all that. But this is for a 12 by 12 inch pillow insert is what the pattern is written for. Besides your yarn, your hook, and your pillow, of course, you're going to need some scissors and a darning needle or tapestry needle in order to weave in your ends. Luckily, there are not a lot of ends in this, so yay! Okay, I know that I said that this crochet along officially starts on May 15th, but I'm going to give you a little head start because part 1 is assembling your yarn. Now, this is a similar yarn to the one that I used here. If you order from High Desert Yarn, your yarn is going to come similar to this in a hank. Now, hanks are kind of difficult to work up your pillow without doing anything special to it. I will be teaching you how to turn your hank into a cake so that you can easily center pull your yarn and crochet your pillow with me. So that will be part 1, assembling all of your materials and turning your yarn into a form that you can do something with it. Okay, and then part 2, I'm going to be teaching you how to do the jasmine stitch, and we're going to be making a gauge swatch. So the jasmine stitch is this beautiful stitch here. It's a combination of puff stitches crocheted in such a way you get these 6 petaled flowers. Isn't that so beautiful? So part 2 is an important step because 1, you're going to be learning the jasmine stitch, and 2, you're going to be making your gauge swatch. You're going to make sure that your hook size and your tension matches mine so that what you make based on my instructions creates this 12-inch pillow. Some people like to skip this step and don't want to measure their gauge, and you know, that's fine, to each their own. I don't often measure my own gauge, but what that means is that your pillow case will be just a different size than a 12 by 12 inch pillow. After you complete step two and you have your gauge swatch and your practice sample, don't throw away because we're going to use it a little bit later. But part three, we're going to create the back panel. We're going to take what we learned on how to crochet the jasmine stitch and make up a 12 inch square so we get our back panel. So that will be part three. This takes a little bit of time. It took me a little bit. So I'm going to give you a couple days to do that. And then part four is the front panel. And you guessed it, we're going to take our gauge swatch and add a modified moss stitch around it in order to create the front panel. Isn't that just a beautiful texture? Love it. Then the final part is part five, where we're going to seam the panels together and sew our pillow and then embellish it a little bit. Look at these cute little tassels. So those are the five parts: assembling your yarn, making your gauge swatch, learning the stitch, doing the back panel, doing the front panel, and assembling your pillow. Don't worry, I'm going to explain that again when each new section is released. All of the information is going to be below on the webpage for the Crochet Along, so click that link below. Each section also comes with its own video where I'm going to be explaining each section's kind of step by step. So I've created a YouTube playlist for this Crochet Along that will be updated when each new section is released and that video is available. Make sure that you're subscribed to all of the things. Subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit that little bell so you're notified anytime that a new video is released. Subscribe to my email newsletter, also linked below, so that in your email you get notified each time a new section of the cowl is released and any other information about the cowl. I'm going to be sending other emails as well. You can unsubscribe to that newsletter anytime. I'm not offended. And then also make sure that you are following along on the Juniper and Oaks Crochet Community Facebook group. That is where you can post pictures, ask any questions, share advice, just be an awesome crochet community in there. I'm also linking that down below. Okay, I've mentioned that this Crochet Along is free on my website. I know some people like to print out their patterns. They don't want to wait each day as the next section is released. They don't like all the ads that are on my website. I get it. I understand. So I have created a full pattern PDF download for you. So you can get the full pattern, no ads. You can print it out, hold it in your hands. That full pattern will be available on May 15th. If you pre-order the pattern before May 15th, you can get the pattern for 50% off. That's a good deal. Everyone who purchases the pattern on or before May 15th will also be invited to a private Sip and Stitch event that we're going to have on Zoom. So that'll be exciting. So you're definitely going to want to pre-order or purchase this ebook. Even if you purchase it after the cowl, there's other bonuses that are involved too. So boom! Thank you so much for supporting me in that way. I just love my crochet community. You guys, I want to see this pillow out there in the world. I want to see this pillow in pictures and reels around the globe. Whenever I get an email or see a picture of someone who's made my pattern, it really touches my heart, and sometimes it almost brings a little tear to my eye. The fact that a design that I made is out there in the world and somebody else made it, like, how cool is that? I just love this job so much. So when you create your pillow or while you're working on it, post a picture on Instagram, create a reel or a TikTok or whatever, tag me. I'm at Juniper and Oaks, OAKES, on all the things. So make sure you tag me and then use the hashtag Desert Flower Pillow. And I would just love to see your work. For whoever posts a reel or a TikTok, a video on social media and tags me at Juniper and Oaks and I see it, it could be your finished product, it could be a work in progress, it could be anything else kind of to get this, the name of this pillow out there, I will send you a little goodie. So definitely post pictures, hype this up. Anytime that you see the cowl, share the picture, and let's try to get this pillow cowl being made all around the world. I love it. I love this pillow. It's like one of my favorite things that I've ever made, and I know you're gonna love it too. Click down on the link, the webpage for this cowl, so that you don't miss any of the information. If you haven't already, please like this video so that more people can find it. Leave a comment below. Are you going to participate in this cow? What yarn are you going to use? And also, what country are you from? I want to know from all around the globe who is going to be working up this cow. Make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that little bell so you're notified anytime I come out with a new update for this cow or any other yarn related content. Happy crocheting!